Let us first go through the map function. So here I am defining a variable which is a list of three numbers, first underscore list 2, 4, 5, control enter, and then let us try to print the output of map. So here in the map we have to use a lambda function. So what the lambda function does, it is returning, it is the input parameter is x, and it will read the value from the first list, and the first list is having 2, 4, 5 as a number, and the output will be the square. So what it will do, first x will be 2, so my output will be 4, second will be 16, and third will be 25. So my output will be also be the list. So here we have an error. Actually, we have to use the list. So my output is also a list, 4, 16, 25. Now the same logic can be written in a different way, which is by using function def square return n, and then when we print the list and map it, 4, 16, 25. So here what we are doing here is that in the square it function we are passing the parameter the values from the first list. So it is going to map each value from the first list into square it function, and then it is going to return the output, which is the square of each element in the list, 4, 16, 25. Let us see another way of writing. So we are having two lists here. Now I want to return a third list, which is the sum of these two lists. So how we can do by lambda function. So here I am having two variable x and y, which is actually a function, which is actually a sum of x and y. So we are passing two lists as a parameter, sum list 2, and my output will also be the list, which is the sum of the two. Let us see a function with the string as an element. So I am having two famous names, Nikola, James, Albert, and then I have a Tesla, Watt, Einstein as the last name. So I want to join these two, Nikola, Tesla, James, Watt, Albert, and Einstein, and the first letter of the name should be capital. So here I am using a lambda function, lambda x and y. So x0 means it is going to return the first letter of the word Nikola, upper, it will convert to upper, plus x1 colon. So it's going to read all the string character starting from the first. So basically if it is Nikola, n will be capital because x 0 upper is making it capital, and IKOLA will be dealt in x1 colon, same way y0, and my output will be finally Nikola, Tesla, Jensen. This is what we are expecting. Let us see the filter. The compilation and the work of filter is almost similar to the map function. It is just that it is going to return the output which satisfy the condition. So here I am trying to divide by 3. If it is divisible by 3, it will return the num elements, otherwise it will not return the element. So I am having a list, my underscore list, which is having 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 as the list of number. So what I am going to do, I am going to use the filter condition. The filter condition here is the element should be divisible by 3, only then it will pass, it will return as true, otherwise false. So 3, 6, 9. So my 4, 5, 7 and 8 are not printed because they are not divisible by 3, and that does not satisfy the filter condition. Now there is another filter where I am going to print all those values which are greater than 3. So I'm filter, I'm using lambda function here, lambda. So it is going to return the x only if it is greater than 3. So my output here, m filter and m list. So I'm supplying the m list into m filter, and my output will be the numbers greater than 3, which is 4 and 5. Okay, reduce. So reduce here, what it will do, it will take the output of one iteration into as the input in the another iteration. So first of all, reduce is part of the library func tool. So here we are going to import. I think you are encountering first time. So these are the inbuilt library in Anaconda, and I'm importing a function reduce from the func tool. So I'm going to have a range. So this range is going to return 1, 2, and 3. So what I'm going to do, I'm adding up the value. So here x will give me the current value, and the x will give me the total value, and y will give me the current value. So here y is adding x plus y. So initially my x will be 0 and y will be 1, because range is 1 to 4. I think in the previous, let's see the previous here. Somewhere we have written a range function, the loop. Okay. If you see here, let's copy this one. Okay, my range is 1, 2, 3. So the first one, my y will be having 0 plus 1, y will be having 1. In the second iteration, x will be 2 and y will be 1, so 3. In the third iteration, x will be 3 and y will be 3, so 6. So my output will be 6.